Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about what are globals in Node.js. Okay, so here we have entered into the Node.js CLI, and here when we do global, right, we are able to get a lot of different things, right? So what are globals in JavaScript? Like we have a process variable for the Node.js process, we have modules, we have a globals. So what is the significance of all these variables, how they are going to help your Node.js program or Node.js process you are writing? Okay, so first of all, let's see what do we have in the globals. So Node.js is a browserless environment, right? So we don't have a Windows object and document object, but something we have is a global. So global contains all these arguments. You can say when you say global dot, if you try to see what is there inside it, you can see a lot of different things, right? Global.net. So these are actually some of the predefined modules which are coming with the Node.js process. So Node.js is a runtime environment, right? Like if you see Node.js global.v8, right? Global.http. These all are actually predefined set of functionalities coming with the Node.js process. So when I say global here, I'm getting the global, and these are the default methods, right? So these are available all the times in your application. You can do set timeout, set time interval, clear timeout, set immediate, right? These are available in your JavaScript also. Like if I do file name or dir name, so it should give you the current directory. If I just do file name, so it will actually try to give you the current file name, and here directory name is giving you the current directory. So, and if you try to execute set timeout, which is a timer function of a JavaScript, I'm not doing anything in this, and it should execute after 1000 milliseconds. I hope you have used this method, and in the client side at least, these are the timer methods are same. Okay, so after 1 second, you can see hello world is coming up, right? So what all other things we have in the global? So global dot, if you try to see this, in the global we have a lot of different things. You just write global dot and then enter tab, so you can see all the different things. So here you can see the FS module, something which is going to deal with the file system, while read write HTTP module, which is going to help you to create server or get the data from another HTTP instance. HTTP2 is also supported, right? DNS, .NET, crypto. These are some of the core modules which are available for your Node.js instance. Like if I do HTTP, here I can also access HTTP server. It's actually a function. So if I just say some port, right, so what it does, it has created one process and it has bind that port to 3001. So if I do curl, yes, it is listening to that port because we are not responding with any message, so it is trying to connect only. Okay, so similarly we have like global.fs. this is another module. You should see something global.fs.read. Okay, and here you can see this is a function, so it will take some argument like the file name which you are going to read, and we are not passing it. So we can see all these different things in the global. Now if you talk about the process contains all the runtime argument which process needs, right? So if I just try to see what process contains, just do a process dot, just hit tab after this, and we can see this, right? Process dot current working directory, process dot exit. This we use to exit from a particular program, right? So it has been exit, right? I'm coming back again. Now you can see the process dot kill, process dot PID, all these command line options, process.env. So this is actually used for Node.js process to set the environment. So currently what all different runtime environment I have, like these are the basic runtime argument I have in my application. Okay, what are the other variables we can look at, like what is the node version manager, node version manager directory, all the things are available in the process of e.env. Now you can see all the other options also here. These are actually helpful when you are actually running, writing a command line for Node.js. Sometimes you need to know the environment variables, like what all runtime argument you are passing. So you will be accessing it using process.env. You want to check, okay, how many process cores, how many CPU cores are involved, how many CPU core the system is having. Based on that, you are going to fork the process. So in that case, this process variable will be helpful. Okay, so this we are talking about the runtimes. Now, what all things you can do with the Node.js? So Node.js has some core inbuilt modules which you can use, like HTTP module, file system module, .NET, DNS. All these are actually predefined inbuilt modules in the node process. Sometimes when you are not able to find some module, then you obviously you will go outside in the npmjs.com and you will explore there, and you will find some package which you wanted to do, and then you do the npm install. So we will talk about that node package manager to install the third party module from outside. Okay, apart from that, there is a module. So module, what module is doing is, sometimes, okay, your project will not have a single file, right? You are going to have many multiple files, and you will be importing, exporting files, right? You will be importing the library from one file to, you will be exporting a file from one file, and then in another file you will be importing that module. Okay, you have written one Fibonacci module which is going to return you the Fibonacci series. So you have to export that Fibonacci from some one file, and you have to require that, like I have to write require and that file name to get it. So right, currently app.js is already there in the current folder, so I can do the require, right? So what require is doing, require will actually get things from the app.js, what is being exported from there. So we talk about any programming language, java.net, you have a export import logic, right? Something you are exporting from one file, and then you will be doing import in another file. The same thing we do in the Node.js. What we do is we write module.exports, and here I will be exporting from some file, and from another file I will be doing require to get what you have exported. So here const data equal to this. This is how the module works. Okay, so what do you have in the module? You have a imports, exports, right? What this module is exporting, module is loaded, true and false, what file you are actually going to import, export. Okay, so this is what the another Node.js global variables contains. We talked about current directory, dir name, process, globals, and module. So all these things are required for the Node.js instance. Globals you can use at different places, like if you wanted to set something, global.data equal to something, then you can use it. Now something you wanted to set globally for your Node.js process instance, like your database configuration, db can be object where you have the name of the database and connection, right? So you can set something to the global object, and that will be available throughout the application if you wanted to just set something global to the Node.js process. Okay, so we talked about all these things, what is global, what is process object, and what is this module object. Okay, so now in the next example we will see how we can actually pass the Node.js command line argument and how we can get it in the Node.js code.